In this video, I'll take a break from specific mechanisms and focus on an important phenomenon that arises in many reactions. And this is the concept of the hydride or the alkyl shift. A hydride is a hydrogen atom along with two electrons and a negative charge, and an alkyl shift is the shift of an entire R group. Having done many reactions, you will recognize that the rate or speed of a reaction depends on the stability of the intermediates. If you have a reaction that undergoes a stable intermediate, the reaction will happen quickly, but if the reaction undergoes an unstable or less stable intermediate, it will happen more slowly. A common example of this is the idea of a carbocation formation. If you have a leaving group on a tertiary carbon, this will give you a tertiary carbocation, which is very stable. When you have a leaving group on a secondary carbon, you will form a secondary carbocation, which is stable, but not as stable. And finally, when you have a leaving group on a primary carbon, the carbocation that would form is so unstable that this actually will not be seen in reactions. For a more in-depth explanation of carbocation stability, go ahead and watch my carbocation video. Assuming you understand the concept, let's move on. At times, you'll come across a reaction where the carbocation that forms is the more stable of possibilities. For example, in this hydrohalogenation of an alkene, the reaction will start out as a standard alkene reaction with the Markovnikov or secondary carbocation forming as a result of the pi bond attacking the hydrogen. I get the hydrogen on the terminal carbon and a positive charge on the secondary carbon. However, this carbocation is located next to a tertiary carbon, which would ultimately form a more stable carbocation. So how can I get the carbocation in the tertiary position if the double bond is only on a primary and on a secondary carbon? And this is where the concept of the hydride shift comes in. The hydrogen is bound to the carbon with two electrons. In a hydride shift, I get the entire hydrogen plus electrons jumping over to the less stable position, thus creating a deficiency in the tertiary carbon. A quick formal charge on the tertiary carbon shows that what started out as a carbon with four bonds now has only three, and therefore a positive charge forms on the most stable carbon of this molecule. The movement of this hydrogen with its electrons is called a hydride shift, and since the carbocation that forms is a lot more stable, this will happen rather quickly. And when the bromide ion in solution comes to attack, it winds up attacking at the tertiary rather than the secondary position. The final product for this molecule is a bromine added in a tertiary position, despite the fact that the double bond only started out between a primary and a secondary carbon. Let's look at another example. For this reaction, let's look at the acid-catalyzed hydration. As with any alkene addition, the pi bond will reach out with its electrons to grab a hydrogen and collapse these electrons onto the water molecule. In addition to the H2O forming, I also have two potential carbocation intermediates where the double bond broke. I have the option to place the hydrogen in two positions to give me two different carbocation intermediates. The tricky aspect is that both intermediates have secondary carbocations. And so in order to predict the product, you have to think one step further. On the left, I have a secondary carbocation directly near a tertiary position with a free hydrogen. On the right, the carbocation only has secondary carbon neighbors. And so while it will form, it will be a minor product, while the structure on the left will be the major product. And the reason for that is the hydrogen, with its lone pair of electrons, can perform a hydride shift and take the place of the secondary carbocation, providing a deficiency in the tertiary position and therefore a stable tertiary carbocation intermediate. Jumping ahead a few steps, I wind up with an alkyl in the tertiary position directly neighboring the secondary carbon which originally held my double bond. What if instead you're faced with a double bond next to a quaternary carbon or carbon having four groups attached to it and no hydrogen to perform a hydride shift? The reaction starts out the same way, where the pi electrons grab the hydrogen and collapse the bonding electrons onto the chlorine. In addition to a Cl- in solution, the hydrogen adds to the Markovnikov position, giving me a secondary carbocation. In this situation, because the secondary carbocation is directly neighboring a quaternary carbon, and the fact that there are no hydrogens on this quaternary carbon, we will shift the next best group. These lines here represent methyl groups attached to the quaternary carbon by a pair of electrons. In an alkyl shift, specifically here a methyl shift, the entire CH3 group with its lone pair of electrons will jump over towards the secondary carbocation to free up a space at the quaternary, now tertiary position. This gives me a methyl group in the secondary, now tertiary position, and a carbocation in the newly formed tertiary position. This happens rather quickly, and so when the chloride ion comes to attack, it winds up attacking the tertiary carbocation to give me a final product where the chlorine is added in the tertiary position. When you see these reactions, it helps to understand the mechanism, but you don't always have to go through every step to give the reaction. If you recognize your double bond is located next to a carbon that is more substituted, try to envision what can possibly shift to give you a more stable intermediate and place your product there directly. For more information about organochemistry reactions, join my mailing list at layitforsci.com/organicchemistry.